Hello everyone. Welcome to the Matrixers Shiva and Jonathan. Yes, welcome to a new video, an exciting video we think. As always, nearly. And this time it's about false memories. And real memories. We were all born. All with a false identity. Let's say 99.9% except for the few conscious walk-ins. Yes, with a false identity and probably partly with false memories. Yes, that is exactly what will be our topic today. Yes, again a very interesting topic, because if you look at what you remember in your life, how can you be sure that all these memories really happened? Correct. You don't have anyone who would tell you, yes, this memory is real, this is not real. But in most cases, a person assumes that all the memories they have of their school days, their parents, their job, all the partners they had are all real. But is this really the case? Normally, you assume that as a human, one is born. So you are in the womb, you are born, you are raised, you go to school, you have a job, you have friends, blah blah blah. But let's say that in many cases this is not the case at all. The soul has perhaps been through a birth 100 times. You also have to consider that you often want to experience an incarnation again. That means you can do your incarnation. Live through and think to yourself, oh, I would like to do it again because it was so exciting, or I would like to try a different path. You can assume that you have experienced your incarnation many times and you have had many incarnations that you may have experienced many times. And you don't want to start every incarnation with the womb, or with birth, or with school. Maybe you would like to get into the body at a certain point in time. So let's say at 30 up to this point, at 30, this body was maybe just an empty shell, an extra. Maybe someone else was inside. And maybe you're a starseed and you have a mission and you don't want to come into the body until you are 30. Many possibilities. Yes. Well, most people even believe in reincarnation. If you look at all the countries in the world, most countries actually believe in reincarnation. And there is not only Buddhism that believes in reincarnation, but there are other religions and other worldviews that include reincarnation. And how do you normally imagine reincarnation? Normally, you imagine that you will be born as a baby. Life lives, then eventually dies, one then goes into the light. And there one is then sent again into the next incarnation and is then reborn as a new baby. But this is not the case. This is the classic reincarnation theory as it is taught, but actually represents the first stage of this teaching. There is a second level, which is intended more for advanced users. And then we are talking about the possibility that memories can also be recorded within the 3D matrix. Technically, because the whole 3D matrix is a simulation, and a simulation makes it possible to start at any starting point with the corresponding memories. So that means if you weren't born a baby at all, your time of entry was much later. Maybe at the age of 6, at 20, at 30, as you say. Or at 40 years old. And as soon as you enter this life, of course, the amnesia takes hold. You don't remember where you came from. You usually don't remember your previous lives and just live your life. And then the associated memories are fed in, of school, work, family, etc. and those memories are deceptively real. You cannot distinguish them from the real memories you have experienced. At least it's very, very difficult. Yes. And today we want to show you a way that you can possibly collect evidence for yourself personally, how to distinguish between real and false memories. What else has to be said is that there are of course many souls who also want to experience birth. So it's not like most people don't get into it until they're 6 or 20. Of course there are also those who want to know how it feels in the womb. How does giving birth feel? How does it feel to be a baby? Of course, there is also the classic way, and they take all the memories with them. So they really experienced everything. So of course there is, we don't rule that out. Yes, clues. Exactly. And what is also possible is that you look into the body from time to time. Practically, that means the truth is you don't go in until you're 20, but you go in at the age of 2 for an hour or 3 days and see what's going on in the body. How that feels, then you go in again at 8, for a few days or a week, or for a month, I don't know, but the real entry point won't be until 20. You can always come and visit in between, that's fine too. The same game also applies to walk-ins. A walk-in is someone who, for example, approaches a person who has been in a coma as a result of an accident. And the coma patient doesn't want to go back into the body. He then likes it outside the 3D matrix so much that he says to himself, "Yes, I don't want the body anymore. I'd rather wait for my next incarnation." If you want, you can take over the body and then a walk-in soul comes along and says, "Yes, that's ideal. I really like the environment you created and the family you have and how you built it all up. I take over your life." Yes, and the walk-in soul then goes into his body and then gets all the memories that he had just experienced up to this point in time. Of course, the new soul already has a different personality. The family members often notice that when he wakes up from the coma, he is somehow different. Because that's true, he's somehow different. But the walk-ins don't just happen when you fall into a coma, they also happen, as I said, even when you come out of the cryocapsule, you're acting as an extra, so to speak. So you go with your soul into an empty body, into an empty shell. Or you can of course come from the astral plane and say, "Hey, I want to be a walk-in now, I want to be born now at 25, as a soul so to speak." And then you pick an empty body that's been walking this planet for 25 years and you go in there. It doesn't have to be a coma. It goes like this, of course. Yes, of course, that's also possible. So if you think back to your school days, for example, then you might think, "My God, I wouldn't feel like going through that whole school thing again in my next life." It may well be that you think so. One thinks, "Yes, I can imagine going through another incarnation. But please without going to school. Can't you get in there somehow at 18 or something or at 16? Where you might be at the end of school, or where you just finished school and the like. And yes, your memories of your school days, nobody can guarantee you 100% that the memories were really all as you remember them. Perhaps these are recorded memories so that you have a seamless past for your mind, for your reason. Because the camouflage for your false identity in the 3D matrix has to be preserved. And that means that there must be an unbroken past here, at least for creating an impression of the personality. So that when the personality questions itself and says, "Yes, was I at school like all the others?" Then the memories of school days come up. What is not possible is that you come as a walk-in and occupy another body where there is already a soul. That is not possible. As I said, as a walk-in you can either come into an empty physical shell, an extra as we call it, or you can swap places with a coma patient, where the other soul agrees. Like I said, you can't cast anyone. It is always an understanding between souls. To be clear, no one can just force you out of your body and then suddenly occupy your body and you're out. That will not do. Yes, and also the starseeds among you who came in here via the cryocapsule, they sit down in front of their cryocapsules and then program. Yes, I would like to experience this and this and this and this. I would like to have these encounters. I want to experience the adventure, or I want to live a completely chilled life, etc. And then the program, the AI of the cryocapsule, starts to search through all the extras until it finds the right one and then says, yes, you are compatible with this extra in terms of frequency. It has roughly your frequency. You can take it and then put it you. Get into your capsule, into your cryocapsule, and then the program starts. Exactly. And of course, the memories are also recorded there, just in a technical way. So if you then take over the extra, who is 25 years old, then memories must exist. Otherwise, the illusion of the 3D matrix is endangered and then, of course, cannot be maintained. For this reason, fake or uploaded or uploaded memories so important upon entering the 3D matrix. Unless you're a starseed and want to consciously serve a mission here, that is also possible. Then of course you get the false memories too, but you don't have amnesia and you're fully conscious in here. You know you're in a cryocapsule on your spaceship right now, so you actually have both memories. You have the memories from the 25-year-old body, all of which actually never really happened. And you have the memory of your true home planet, where you came from, your spaceship, who you really are and stuff like that. That is also possible. Yes, but first of all it rarely happens, and secondly these memories are also diluted from incarnation to incarnation. Yes, that is also a problem. It can also be that you came in here starseed at some point, lived through an incarnation, conscious with your memories, with the knowledge that you came in here via the cryocapsule and then live your life and die, go to the astral plane, go into the next incarnation and then you only remember half of it. Yes, that's exactly what happened. Yes, that is a problem that occurs very often because the frequency, the 3D matrix frequency is much lower than the 5D matrix frequency. And because of that, the memories get watered down more and more until at some point you're just as stupid as everyone else. Yes, exactly. Then a few clues. How one could recognize, is my memory real or not? So we don't have any evidence for that, nor do we really know. As I said, these are indications. We're assuming if, for example, you have a really, really early memory. For example, you were maybe a year and a half old. This could have been a real memory because normally people don't remember prenatal stories, nor the birth itself, nor early childhood. For example, I have a memory when I was only a year and a half old. How likely is it to remember something like that? Otherwise, I have maybe three or four memories from my childhood altogether, until I was about 11. Maybe it was five or six. As I said, I only got into my body much later. Not when I was born, but I seem to have looked in from time to time, and for me that is evidence that I have looked in from time to time. Namely, when I was 1.5 years old I looked in, I remember one or two scenes. And with three or four times too. Every now and then I took a 2-day vacation in my body to get used to it, and then at some point later I really got into it. And it was the same for you. You didn't come here when you were born. No, that's right. For example, if you try to remember your school days, try to remember who you were sitting next to. And now look at the memory. Does this memory exist as a sequence of several scenes? Oh, yes, exact. Very right. Good point. Yes. Or do you just have a photo? Correct. Exactly. How you were sitting next to your classmate with whom you always messed around so much. Correct. The photos, yes. And that's where you can differentiate. Is your memory a short film, a short scene of several images running, or just a photo? And if you just have a photo, then that's an indication for us that it's a well-rehearsed memory. Correct. We talk very intensively about this. Exactly. The photo story and the sequence story. And to that end, you can check out your whole past a bit, your memories of your school days. Because the school days could be suspected that many would like to skip that. Because it wasn't that exciting. Some might think their school days were great and say, wow. So school was the best time of my life. There are also people who thought it was great, the school days. But as I said, it's just an example with my school days. Check your memories. How do the memories appear in your head? Photo or film? A second point is, of course, the memory discrepancy, I would call it. That is, when your parents tell you, Ha, remember when you were 3 with that weird red tricycle? You drove into a park bench once. And you have no idea what they're talking about. Yes, you then think to yourself, how? I never had a tricycle. Never. But your parents swear by it. No, we gave it to you for Christmas. Do you remember that? And you like, no plan. Then, of course, that is an indication that you were apparently not yet in the body. Of course, this also works the other way around. I once did when I was 5, so I have a memory in my head. I'm 100% sure that's how I experienced it. Then I asked my mother, yes, you remember that back then and that wasn't so nice when you were 5, and she was like, no, that never happened. Never. And she was 100% sure. No way I've ever experienced that. But I have that so clear in my head. We also have a very strong memory discrepancy. Yes, that can then be explained by the fact that you may have been there in another reality. Either that maybe you weren't even in your body at the time, or that, of course, a different reality was somehow imported afterwards. Either with you, or with your parents. Yes, exactly. So there you can see what possibilities exist. And usually you can't distinguish between false memories and memories that you have actually lived through now. Another indication for me is the emotional connection to a memory. If you feel a certain longing for this memory, it's not a judgmental emotion. It's not that it was particularly nice or particularly negative. It's actually more that you have a feeling, a mood about a memory. Then it already indicates that it is a real memory. If it's just, let's say, an inanimate emotion, so if you don't really feel anything, it will probably break in. It doesn't have to be that way. But once you have some kind of feeling about a memory, it's definitely real. This is not proof, just an indication. My opinion. It feels like it's going to be consistent. For me anyway. Yes, in this context we naturally have another very exciting topic on the subject of memories. Because memories can not only be uploaded or exchanged individually, it can, of course, also be a worldwide mass event. Yes, en masse. has happened more often. For example, when they changed the story again. Time travel is possible, no kidding. And if something went wrong again and something really stupid happened that people are not supposed to know, it can well be that the memories were either deleted, exchanged, or taken back in time. There are a lot of options there. Or the reality was switched. Or the reality was switched. And not individually, but en masse. So collectively, the reality has been switched. Such as the Mandela effect. Exactly. The Mandela effect is a topic that is being discussed again and again in some forums at the moment. It's called Mandela because you all know Mandela. And if we ask you now, when did he die? When do you think he lived and when did he die? That's where the statements differ. For me, he died in 90. Yes, and for me in the 60s. Oh shit, wow. Just it. That's how I remember it. Hmm? Yeah, what's right now? Oh well, so the truth is I think he died sometime around 2000-something. I do not know it either. You have so many dates in your head now as to when he died. Or it wasn't important. We'll write it down for you. Perhaps. And there are other stories too. For example, Monopoly. You all may have played Monopoly with your parents or with friends. And there is a character who wears a top hat, looks a bit like an older gentleman, and did he have a monocle? Yes. I think so, too. But as far as I know, he shouldn't have that. No, he definitely had a monocle. That's where it, and I've never played Monopoly. Or here, one of the most famous James Bond films, Moonraker. Yes, with Roger Moore. And in this movie, there's a little blonde girl who messes with the Walker. That was some hired killer who was supposed to kill James Bond. And then he fell in love with a blonde, a little girl with pigtails. Dungarees, like you. And she had braces. And then there was a very special scene in which the blonde and he both grinned. And he had steel teeth, which he usually used to bite his victims to death or something. And she just had a metal brace. And in a certain scene, the two just smiled into the camera. And then you thought, okay, so they have something in common. Well, but if you look at Moonraker now, that brace isn't there. How does this happen? Yes. Why does everyone who saw that movie remember the braces? And why is she suddenly gone? So these are all images that come under the umbrella term Mandela effect. People have a very different memory as it really is. Of course, this also applies to larger things. Wars. Entire epics can have been exchanged in memory that never happened in this way. For example, the Tatars or any wars. You can imagine it like this. Watch the movie Jupiter Ascending. In one scene, the war broke out in the back and high-rise buildings were destroyed. And then the girl drives away with this guy and says, oh shit, what are people going to say tomorrow or what about those who have seen this now? According to the motto, yes, tomorrow nobody will know anything about it and everything will be the same as before. That's how it works. So the film as a whole is very close to the truth. It's more of a kind of documentary for us too. But that's how you can imagine it. Time is simply turned back. Everything is rebuilt and yes, the memories are deleted or updated like with My Black. Yes, or here, Eric von Daniken. Yes, exactly. Of course, we wanted to give a personal example. Yes, well, I was on YouTube sometime many years ago. I don't know when that was, 8 years ago, I think, or something like that, I have no idea. 2014, 15, sometime around the shoot. I saw a video on YouTube in which Eric von Daniken's wife had just been interviewed. And how she now wants to carry on Eric von Daniken's legacy now that he has passed away. Yes, and I thought, oh, Eric von Daniken is dead. Yes, too bad. Okay. And then I listened again and what she then said. And from that moment on, I believed that Eric von Daniken had died. Yes, then we met at some point. Yes, then we met at some point and talked about Eric von Daniken. And I was also absolutely convinced that he had died a long time ago. And how did we come to the conclusion that he is actually still alive? Because we were both firmly convinced that Eric von Daniken had died a long time ago. For both of us. Well, at some point someone wrote me an email because I mentioned it in passing in a blog article. Oh, I see. Yes, then at some point someone wrote me an email and said to me, "What are you talking about? Eric von Daniken is still alive." And I... like that. That can't be true. And then I researched. And indeed, Eric von Daniken is alive. Yes, he is fit as a fiddle and to this day you can see that he tweets all his stuff. And that wasn't the case in my reality. Neither does mine. Yes, so... you can say that playing in false memories or a change of reality somehow always goes hand in hand. Yes. Yes, I find it very exciting, because you simply never know what we have really experienced. Is what we experienced yesterday true? Or maybe yesterday was the apocalypse and my memory of it was just wiped out. Who knows? Yes, that was our false memories video. My dear, we have created a beginner video course for all newcomers to the Matrixers. You are welcome to take a look at www.matrixer.com. A real seminar of, I don't know, 8 hours or so. We have put it together especially for you and it is free of charge. Exactly. So it's a good introduction to the topic, the Matrix. An introduction to our knowledge of where we got our knowledge from. The main topics we cover. We've packed everyone into this free seminar. You can register. Just enter a name, email address is enough and then you can take part in the free online seminar. We wish you a lot of fun with it and see you next time. And don't forget to comment. Don't forget your comments. Yes. Ciao.